Hello everyone, I hope you all are fine. So let's start our today's session. In our today's session, I have brought the study of coordination compound. Okay, so before starting the study of coordination compound, let us understand what are double salt. Okay, so as it is getting clear from the name, this is the combination of two different salts. Okay, so these are the addition compound which are stable in solid state but break up into its constituent when dissolved in water or in any other solvent. Okay, and in individual properties are not lost, but whenever they dissolve in water, the double salt that lose its identity, that we have to understand. So I have written here the few examples of double salt. One is to be of Mohr salt, potash alum and carnallite. Mohr salt, that is the combination of ferrous sulfate and ammonium sulfate, and simply we can call it, this is a ferrous ammonium sulfate, and here 6 moles of water, that shows their water of crystallization. Next it is of potash alum. This is the combination of potassium sulfate and aluminium sulfate. Then 24 moles of water, this is the water of crystallization. In the same way, carnallite, this is the combination of potassium chloride and magnesium chloride. Okay, so let's see here. First of all, we will understand what is the complex ion. Complex ion, this is an electrically charged species carrying either the positive or the negative charge. Okay, in which central metal atom or ion is surrounded by fixed number of ions or molecule. I mean to say, the complex ion will be electrically charged species. When it will be charged, that means it will contain either the positive or the negative charge. And here the central metal, that is to be surrounded by fixed numbers of ions or molecules. And these fixed numbers of ions or molecule will be known as ligands. Okay, so now you see here that few examples I have written, that comes in a square bracket, that CO, this is cobalt, NH3 whole 4, then 2 positive charge. So this is cationic species, and here this is of anionic species because it is carrying a negative charge. But the charge should be present, that shows that this is of complex ion. Okay, ions, that means that must have some charge. Okay, the complex ion does not dissociate into the simple ion. Here the point, whenever coordination compound is to be dissolved in water, then the complex ion part, that never dissociate. Okay, then the ionic part which is coming outside the square bracket, that gets dissociate. So just understand that, come on the point of coordination compound. These are the compound which contain complex ion. These compounds contain a central metal or cation which is attached with a fixed number of anions or the molecule called ligand. Is it clear? That we have to know the central metal that is surrounded by the numbers of atom, ions or molecule, and these are to be known as ligands. Okay, then in the next session we will study about the type of ligands also. Okay, so let's understand how does the coordination compound look. So as we make the representation of coordination compound, so how it is to be represented, first of all we have to make a big bracket, square bracket. Here we have to mention central metal, CM represents for central metal, and it is to be surrounded by number of ligand, and after that, that number of ligand is to be denoted by CN, that we call it coordination number, and the part which comes outside the square bracket, we call it, this is ionization sphere, and the part which comes in the square bracket, we call it, this is coordination sphere. So you see here, I have written all the parts, CM central metal, L ligand, CN coordination number, IS ionization sphere, CS coordination sphere. So you see here the one example, like suppose CO NH3 whole 6, then Cl3 is to be written. So this is a coordination compound. Here the one important point, the coordination compounds are most probably formed by the D block element. Okay, so cobalt that I have written there, that is, that comes in the D block. Okay, so here you have to see, this is the central metal, and this cobalt will be surrounded by 6 ammonia. So ammonia will be ligand here, and the number which is written after the ligand, that is to be of coordination number. Okay, and the part which is coming outside of this square bracket, that Cl3, this is the ionization sphere. So ionization sphere, either that will be present after the square bracket or before the square bracket. So here you have to understand, whenever that part is come present after the square bracket, then it brings the positive charge on the complex entity, and whenever that part is present before the square bracket, then it brings the negative charge on it. Suppose as you have to dissociate this, so that will dissociate into 4K positive, and that is to be of FeCN whole 6, and this is to be of 4 negative. Okay, so because as you know that always cations are to be written first, then anions are to be written later on. Okay, so that potassium is to be positively charged, so it brings a positive charge on it, and negative charge that will come out complex ion. And in the same way, suppose you have to dissociate this, so that will dissociate in this way, CONH3 whole 6 plus 3Cl negative. So against it, that will carry 3 positive charge on it. Okay, so whenever anion is to be present, that will be present after the square bracket, and the cation that is present before the square bracket. Whenever the part that comes before it, then nothing will come after the square bracket. Okay, that you have to understand. So that dissociation I have showed here, I have written here also. Okay, and after that you have to understand the coordination entity. It constitutes a central matter or ion bonded to a fixed number of molecules or the ions. Okay, so that we call it, this is coordination entity. Now we will talk about the central atom or the ion. So now in a coordination compound entity, the coordination entity, the atoms or ions to which a fixed number of ions or molecules are bound in a definite geometry, that we call it, this is of central atom. So central atom, that always be present in the center. Okay, so like suppose as the CONH3 whole 6, so here cobalt is to be a central metal. Okay, this is of central metal or central metal ion, that you can call it, this is central metal. So that suppose I am showing here, how can you understand in that case CONH3 whole 6. Okay, suppose it is containing 3 positive charge, so that means it will show that cobalt is, it is to be surrounded by 6 ammonia in this 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, that positive charge that is to be mentioned in this way. Okay, so that you have to understand, the cobalt is to be surrounded by 6 ammonia, so that 6 ammonia are to be known as ligand. Okay, so in tomorrow's session we will study about the type of ligands in detail. That's all for today.